Hi, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Nao Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create some gel baubles and an acrylic Christmas bow.
So for the pipe shape, I've already prepped the nail, took the form off and put the tab on the back. Now we're going to match this. So if you look, this doesn't match at all. This smile line doesn't match. We're going to cut this out. So her natural smile line doesn't match the smile line of the sculpting form. So we're going to trim that so it matches better and fits better. Now you need a nice sharp pair of scissors for this. Right, okay. So we're going to do a pipe shape, which, if I described it, is kind of like a slightly tapered square, and it has a sloped profile. Just checking the snug fit. So we're going to do a full cover nail, which means we're going to use natural beige through the entire length of this nail, so you can see the shape of it really well. We're using Max Adhesion liquid and the natural beige powder. I'm going to start here with my first bead to get this free edge shape nice, and I'm going to work my way backwards. Pop that there. Fade it back. Bring it straight from the natural nail fold. I'm going to give it a slightly rounded tip. Second bead, still going to bleed this off. Tap the back of the bead just so it sneaks nice and close to the cuticle area. And we're going to bring this bead down over onto the free edge that we've just made. It's going to bring all the shape together. Check your sides, make sure they come out nice and straight. Okay, let that set up a little bit. So you want a matte finish. So you want a nice straight side, and then you've got a rounded off profile here. So you don't want it square, you want that soft curve. We're going to put the pinching tool on now. We're going to test pinch. That's fine. I'll give that a second, and then what I'll do is I'll move it slightly further down the pinching tool, which will give it a stronger pinch. Make sure you're not pinching the skin at the sides, make sure you're pinching the actual nail. Let that settle. So you've still got your apex coming up out the back third of the nail. And you have a very, very slight slope coming down. Just have a quick check. And it's very, very pinched. And it's not round at the end. So you've got quite a steep arch in there as well. And then it's slightly tapered towards this free edge. So we're going to file this nail now. Same routine as we always do. Straight up the sides, nice and straight. The sides aren't dropping down, they're not lifting up. They're following the natural nail fold. So that side wall needs to just come straight out. Cuticle area. Just whip over there. Make sure it's nice and flush. Make sure you don't file off your apex. It's going to give you a lot of strength. And what the nail needs is a lot of strength and structure. It's going to make it last longer. And if the structure's perfect, it'll look even more beautiful. So now I'm just going to skip over the entire surface. And as I skip over, I can see if there's any spots that dip where my file doesn't hit. So I can then go back over again, contour the surface of that nail. Nice curved edge. So when I'm filing this, I'm actually keeping both. I'm not filing one side, then the other. I'm making contact with both sides. So I file them both exactly the same. So we're starting here and rotate up. I'm just going to take a little bit of bulk off this nail. And then we're pretty much ready to go to buff the nail and top coat it, so you can see all the different curves when that nail's nice and shiny. You'll see everything even more clearer. Just buff this and you'll see the shape even clearer. Make sure you're pulling back the skin and reduce any discomfort to your client. All the angles, happy with that. So when you created this shape, what you're intending to do is to mirror this curve and this curve. So this curve here should be the same as this curve here. Okay. I'm just going to wipe over with some acetone just to smooth over, get rid of any dust, but it's also going to melt the top surface of the nail very, very slightly, which will smooth it even more. And then we're going to use the Mega Gloss Sealer Gel to add a shine. Don't forget, this is purely just so you can see the shape of the pipe nail. You can do a design on this nail. You could do a pink and white nail. You could do a glitter design. This is just purely so you can see the true shape of a pipe nail. Right, so we're going to put that into the UV lamp now for 2 minutes.